start this session with announcement of the time schedule by which we will be going about. For the first 10 minutes, there will be a brief presentation because it was Hemantji's passion and dream that drove me here to this conference of positivity and sustainability. So how we achieve that, that is going to be the core focus of this panel, and that is also part of my 10-minute presentation. After that, there will be a 5-minute presentation by Shri Sanjay Jain. After that, for 30 minutes, we have an exhaustive question-answer round. I have prepared some brief questions from the speakers, but be aware, there are going to be very, very relevant answers to that. And for the last 10 minutes, we will keep the house open if you have any questions. We plan to end this session in 55 minutes flat. So let us hope we can do that. एक प्रार्थना से शुरू करते हैं. सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिना, सर्वे सन्तु निरामया, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुख भाग भवेत्. ओम शांति 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 ही. What do we need today in the textile industry? We need to understand that either all of us will survive और नन विल, या हम सभी बचे रहेंगे. ग्रोथ तो बाद की बात है, या सब डूबेंगे. वी कैन नॉट आइसोलेट एनी सेक्टर फ्रॉम वन अनदर. वी मे बी वेरी पैशनेट अबाउट फार्मिंग, वी मे बी वेरी डिसोसिएटेड अबाउट गारमेंटिंग एंड ब्रांडिंग ऑन द ब्रांड्स, लेकिन इन सबको साथ में चलना पड़ेगा. इन सबको एक दूसरे को समझना पड़ेगा. We have to understand the needs, the requirements, and the difficulties of each textile chain individually. So here we start a step towards sustainable cotton supply. This is a textile chain. The next. Yes, a step towards sustainable cotton supply. Next. This is a textile supply chain. This is one of the longest and the most complex supply chain among all कमोडिटीज. सो इसको समझ के चलना बहुत जरूरी है. नेक्स्ट. 2004, द ईयर दैट वॉज अ ईयर ऑफ मेजर चैलेंजेस. इन द चार्ट वी सी प्रॉफिट्स, दैट इज व्हाट अ कंपनी नॉर्मली प्लान्स एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ द ईयर, दैट वी विल बी क्लाइंबिंग द स्टेप्स ऑफ सक्सेस. एंड प्रॉफिट इज द ओनली टैंजिबल मीन्स टू डिटरमाइन सक्सेस. अगर बैलेंस शीट में प्रॉफिट है तो कंपनी सक्सेसफुल है. But 2014 was not so kind to the textile industry. How? One thing, there was low customer demand. Second thing, a poor monsoon. India is an agri-based economy. A poor monsoon can have a drastic effect on the purchase power of a common man. And the less we grow, may it be food crop, fuel crop, or cotton, the more we need to depend on export or import, rather. Third, the bearish global markets. If we are not doing well, if the world is doing well, then we have a chance to export. But if the world is also not doing well, where do we go? So 2014 brought us on that brink of a decision-making time. कि अगर इंडिया में भी क्रॉप कम हो सकता है या ज़्यादा भी है, पर इधर की मिल्स की डिमांड नहीं है और ओवरसीज भी डिमांड नहीं है, तो where do we go? And this resulted in fall in profit, fall in confidence. The companies all over the world started lowering inventories. They did not want to build on inventory. This directly resulted in fall in demand and fall in the values of textile companies and cotton. Next. Looking on a positive note, 2015, because positivity is the first step towards success. If we believe, we will get. If we do not, we will not. The sooner we learn from our mistakes and focus on our core strengths, the faster we come out of the dark tunnel of a bearish market. Because mandi kahan hai? Dimag mein hai. It is a mind. If I stop buying, you stop buying, if all the people in this conference hall stop buying, that commodity price is going to go down. And this is the trend right now. It is a mindset. So is mindset ko change karna hai. Our success is the result of clear vision, effective execution strategy, and consistency of core purpose and mission. No business can succeed if you are not into it with a core purpose and a clear direction. The vision of the management is most vital. The vision of the government is most important. So this is a learning for us. 2015 with a new government and with the industry in doldrums, in bad shape, this is the time when we fix our vision and the strategic execution. So when you move your focus from competition to contribution, it becomes a celebration. We are not competitors here. We are all partners in this trade. And that is going to bring a celebration in the days to come. Things to do, next. In 2015, what is possible? Farming, getting down to the core level, is farming. Crop yield is the ultimate factor for the prosperity of farmers. Price can vary, but if yield is consistent, at least he doesn't get into a loss. The government must have a master plan for agriculture. That is very vital. Then a transfer of technology to reduce farm input costs. Like we heard from the panel speaker before, the input cost must be considered at all levels before fixing the MSP. And sincere and very rapid efforts must be made to reduce that input cost. Because Brazil has the highest yield under rainfed. The Indian yield is barely 521 kg per hectare. The yield of Brazil is 1522 under rain-fed conditions. Rain-fed conditions, no irrigation. But still the Brazilian farmers are shying away from cotton. They don't want to grow cotton this year. Only because their input cost is so high. They have technology, they have mechanization, they have a market. But still their cost is so high, they don't want to get into cotton. Then optimum use of agri-biotechnology. This is most vital in cotton seeds and advanced breeding for improved germplasm, excellent disease tolerance, high yield potential, and high quality cotton for both irrigated and rain-fed conditions. This is where the research scientists would come in. They would give us a better quality seed which would cater to the specific requirement of the industry. Soil health card to determine the deficiency of nitrogen and phosphorus. These two are found to be most deficient in Indian soil. So there should be a soil health card, like we have a health card. Kya kam hai hamari body mein? Hemoglobin kam hai, to uske treatment karenge. Calcium kam hai, to uske treatment karenge. Like we have already identified, our scientists have, that these are the two ingredients which are in short in the Indian soil, so that should be identified and acted upon. And focus on quality. That is also a thing that we need to look into. Next. Did you look at, can you go back? Yes, the cartoon, I received this as a WhatsApp message about 2 months back. A farmer is asking a scientist, Tantagran itka pude gela manta, mag pani download karta ye nashi ekhadi website kada na. So the farmer is really, he is so innocent that he feels that sab kuch download sakta hai, so why not water? So the first provision that we need to make is the basic need of farming, that is water. Next. Things we need to do in ginning and pressing and for the associations of cotton, need to understand the needs of the spinning industry. We can't stay aloof. Ke mujhe quality kapas seed cotton nahi milta hai, so I can't make a good quality cotton bale. No. You have to understand the need of the spinner. Only then you will have a market. Then you will have a consistent buyer. Achieve global quality standards. India is known to sell cheap. Our cotton is cheaper by 2 to 5% compared to the world origins. We will come to that later. Why? Ensure authorized distribution of economically priced and certified seed varieties for specific fiber quality requirements such as staple length, strength, and micronet. This is the ginner's priority. A farmer cannot regulate this. He cannot ask the seed companies to issue, to distribute seeds of limited quality, certified seeds at economic prices. It is the ginner's priority. Then implement 100%, because that is the world target right now. Countries like US, Brazil, Australia are offering 100% testing facilities. 100%, all the bales in the lot are tested and the reports are given in advance. But we can at least start with 10% to increase the transparency levels of Indian cotton for better marketing. Draft a common cotton contract with provisions for allowances, premiums in quality, and discount interest in payment terms. We do not trade on cotton contract in the domestic trade, but while in export, we have to strictly adhere to it. So, ek India mein common contract kyun na ho? Next. Cotton price movement, this may be of interest to you, ke kya chal raha hai world mein. We can see that starting from January 2014, where the graph is going to. In 2014 December, now in January the prices are same as in November. They have gone lower than the December. The international prices have depreciated by over 30% and the domestic prices by over 20%. Next. Maharashtra, highest potential in India. Why are we here? Because the weakest child with the highest potential is the one we must look into first. And this is the place, Vidarbha, and this is the state, Maharashtra. What we suggest is a Mission 500, a Mission Clean Cotton, building marketing linkages, increase per capita consumption of cotton garments. Next. What is Mission 500? Maharashtra covers 35% of agriculture area under cotton, but contributes to only 22 or 23% of the output. 35% area mein sowing hota hai all over India ke stake mein Maharashtra ka, but the cotton output is only 23%. So the average yield of Maharashtra, as we all know, is 328 kg per hectare. The national yield is 521. The world yield is over 900. Where do we stand? 90% of the cotton cultivated in rain-fed areas. No irrigation in many places. The government must involve research associations and industry to achieve the yield of 500. That is the Mission 500. At least start with 500, if not the national average. So Mission 500 is the one thing which can be taken up in coalition with the government and the research associations, taking the textile corporates into confidence. Next. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is what we all know, is the respected PM slogan. So why can't we have a Swachh Kapas Abhiyan? Next. What is the Swachh Kapas Abhiyan or the Mission Clean Cotton? It is Indian cotton must be branded and positioned in the world like a clean cotton, not Indian cotton. Indian cotton is equal to clean cotton. Clean cotton is equal to Indian cotton. And we can adhere to the national slogan of the respected PM of zero defect, zero effect. Zero defect of contamination and zero effect on environment. That is going towards responsible agriculture. Next. Like Shri Nitin Gadkari ji mentioned in the morning, we can take due advantage of the strategic location of Nagpur in Maharashtra, in India, and India in the world. Like you can see from this chart, India is strategically located among all the cotton consuming countries. Pakistan, China, Vietnam, Indonesia, Bangladesh, all around us. So logistically, we are very well placed to plan our exports. Similarly, Maharashtra is logistically very well placed among all the Indian cotton growing centers. It can supply cotton to North India, South India at very similar logistic prices. Next. Increase per capita consumption of cotton garments and target the domestic market. Make in India. Look into us. Like you can see from the chart, I'll just get to the figures of kg. In kgs, US consumes plus 35 kg per person. China consumes 18 kg. Pakistan consumes plus 6 kg, where the consumption is India is only 4.5 kg. Here we have a gap. Here we have an opportunity. We need not go out of India. We can very well focus on India and try to increase the consumption of cotton in India. How? I mean, that is what our mission is. The next slide, please. This is our mission. Like to assist cotton farmers in improving yield and quality, helping cotton users locate regular sources of quality cotton at nominal prices, and to prevent the arbitrary use of paper and plastic objects where cotton can easily be replaced as a renewable resource. Cloth bags are the right replacement for plastic. Paper bags are not. Paper comes from trees. Trees take 20 years to grow if they do grow. But cloth bags come from cotton. Cotton is grown every year. It is a renewable resource. So that is what, because if we replace plastic by paper today, 10 years down the line, there will be no trees. Then we'll have to find some other resource. And for example, what we can replace, this has been appreciated by the ICAC and the ICA also, that handkerchief, we are so used to using handkerchiefs, but now we are converting to tissue papers. Lakhs and millions of trees are cut to make those tissue papers. Why can't we replace them with a handkerchief? It is very handy, and it lasts at least 1 year to each of us. So the cost is down, and we somehow serve the environment. And as I said, we can replace plastic and paper bags with the cotton bags. Next. So together we can make a difference for a better and a more sustainable world. The effort has to be made all together. An individual cannot do it. And he will not survive if he tries to do it for long. So as a collective effort, we can definitely succeed. There is only positivity ahead. Because if we don't grow, the world is going to grow. If we don't survive, the world will survive. We will die. We will face out. But there can be no negativity when you are in business, when you are in life, or when you are in any stage of your career. Once that negativity seeps in, the failure is the next door, at the next door. So success is directly related to positivity. For the marketing aspects, I would only say that khudi ko kar buland itna, khudi ko kar buland itna ki har saude se pehle buyer khud tujhse puche bol tere bhav kya hai. Thank you.